It's the same thing for a lot of teams. It just feels even though it's harder, it feels nicer to start. It's more fun. It just feels like a better start. Even if you get you're up against less favorable odds, it's something that's just easier to deal with, and you know what you have to go up against when you're in your T half. When you get to dictate the pace of the match, you already know how many rounds you got to pull on the board. So it's like less pressure, even though you could be quite behind. There's less pressure, so I like that.
So apparently it's Shazam's 21st birthday today. So congratulations to you, and may the chicks be with you, dude.
You're a narrow man, and playing CS. That's good. That's good. Everything's right with the world. I don't know why I'm taking this.
All right.
I thought almost I could make something really witty of that, but I just we'll move on now.
Pistol round time, and Denial are gonna go for a straight B, it seems. Let's have a look at what iBuyPower will have to offer these chaps.
It is simple, it is beautiful, and it is swag. With the USP already popping some heads, and it's going to be ATK, he takes down Fugly as well. The kills are raining in here for iBuyPower, and it is an easy cleanup. I do respect the straight up B rush, I respect that, but this time it's not going to work, I'm afraid.
Well, that's the fastest pistol run I think we've seen in this entire league.
Yeah.
So not much to say there. Went for the rush B, didn't work, and it is going to be the scout coming up for Shazam. So let's see if the birthday boy can rip some heads in round two.
This can actually work quite well as well. We got a tag onto ATK, and also it's worth mentioning that Skadoodle's actually keeping just a P250, just a pistol in this round. You know, wants to save that AWP. So actually, this could work out. You know, they're up against some Famases. Just only a couple of M4s. It's not like it's the best buy in the world from iBuyPower. It's still early days. And we get to see the push coming onto Long. Fugly able to drop Skadoodle. Only one frag found for iBuyPower so far. Steel's going to make it two, but not before he goes down swiftly afterwards. So they might just try to get the weapon and get out of there. And there's a deep smoke deck towards a crossover. And a Denial certainly not in the worst positions. They pick up another kill. The scout in hand now for Daps. And might be able to connect something with this, going to play in that pit position. And iBuyPower, certainly it's not advisable to go facing against Daps right now.
Indeed, both players are in the pit, not that iBuyPower are aware, which is why you can see the rotation there from AZK. He's just going to be looking down around the outside of the B-bomb site just to just in case there is a rotation there. Daps, not sure where to put his crosshair, but he has spotted a head on the site. Gonna trade flashbangs and nades. And that's gonna beat Swag on 34 HP and AZK on 54 HP. So it's gonna be a 2v1 here. They've got the frag, that means the bomb's gonna go down.
This is nuts. We're seeing the power come in from Denial on this round, and AZK gonna have to save this. He has to save this. They can't go down in like this on the second round. AZK coming around the side now, and a bit of juking from Fugly and Daps. They're both pretty much on the same angle. And it's going to be AZK to take down one, but Daps, surely he gets this kill. AZK on 3 points of health, surely there's no way, and Daps will take the frag. And this is something, I mean, if we looked at the buy from iBuyPower, sure, it wasn't great. But, you know, definitely there were chances for Denial, but damn, they actually did it. They pulled it off.
Yeah, with a scout and pistols, so it's going to be 1-1 here, round three, and it is going to be iBuyPower now on the eco. Swag with a grenade, P250s on Skadoodle and AZK, and that's about it. Do have a flashbang on Daze as well, so they're going to stack Long, and hope they get something going, but it's not going to happen because we have tentative positioning here from Juvenile. Just going to keep an eye on B tunnels and make sure nobody goes through and gets a flank going. We've got the same thing happening with Denial, and they are going to start to move towards Long now, but there are four people covering the A site area, as we can see here, so not picking the most optimal spot, as they are about to find out.
In comes Daps and Fugly, first kill found, entry onto Steel, then onto Swag, then onto AZK. They are dropping like flies. And of course, they don't really have any armor behind them. No grenades, so it is somewhat expected. And you know what, James? I think that the 21st birthday is much more significant in America than it is here. I mean, it's a big deal here, but in America, it's actually... Oh, damn, you can, you know, legal drinking age.
Yeah, you can go to some bars, drink some water.
Strip clubs.
You don't even have to drink alcohol. You can just get into the bars. You know, it's great.
That's true, actually, yeah.
On my 21st birthday, I went to New York, and Mariah Carey was playing in Times Square.
That sounds cool.
On the day of my birthday, and she has massive boobs.
Oh my god, Skadoodle. Gonna go in there. Does take down a one player. Even though those fall. And trying to get the image of boobs out of my head right now. It's definitely a hard ask, but we'll have to see if Skadoodle can find anything else here. Already putting the stop on denial on that B approach, and they do, you know, it's actually Shazam the man to find the pick towards CT spawn, opening up middle, and Iberpower are going to react to this. They're still only on the pistols, obviously, so it's going to be very difficult for them to really compete, but we do have Steel who pushed around from long, and the bomb is actually dropped on T spawn, so suddenly there could be something found for Iberpower here.
Still being very, very sneaky, allowing Daze to get into an aggressive position here. Going to try and get the frag, but is he going to get there in time?
That was good damage done onto Nap, and Fugly's getting low as well, but it's just Steel that remains. He does pick himself up the AK, but is put down by Denial. So Denial off in with a very good start. We're going to see the buy coming in from Iberpower now, as surely an AWP, maybe even two, can come out from Iberpower. Skadoodle could just, you know, pick up an AWP as well. There it is, the double AWP setup coming into play. So big, big round now for Iberpower. They have to keep the AWPs alive. It's got to be cost efficient, and that's a nice leg shot there onto Swag. Already Denial taking some early advantages as they take long. Nice shot from AZK. And how well can Steel do here? Does take down the bomber. And the bomb does drop behind that smoke. This is a bad situation for Denial, but they are fighting back. Nice grenade there from Naf. And Dazed in that pit, locking it down so far. Needs some cover though.
He's got support coming in from Skadoodle. He's going to hold the angle there, so that means Daze can be a little bit more passive, but the boost is going to make things harder for Daze now. It's going to be harder for him to keep an eye on what's going on. He is going to need to find a connection here, and the connection will be found from Fugly to take out Daze. Then Nade does get some revenge, and Skadoodle's going to be on the car area with that AWP. The bomb is in no man's land at the moment. It's going to be hard for them to get it out of this position. Shazam has seen the gun exposed on the A bomb site. It's going to try and get the frag. Ooh. And there's the first one, and he needs to get out of there. Because, again, the bomb goes down.
Uh-oh. Oh, no. Nice grenade there. Swag does explode. And now it's a one-man advantage. Denial turning this round into something doable, and it's Shazam with the frag at the end. And that's well played by Denial. Just busting that along, picking up the kills, and now Iberpower in a very severe situation. The problem is that they can't get their economy going, and that's really, really sad news for the CTs, not being able to get it going early on. They're going to have to put up with so many weird buys, so we'll have to see how that actually works out for them. But for now, it's just about doing some damage and keeping Denial accountable, as we see them splitting up across the map, just looking for picks and looking for situations to get some guns.
So we've got two long for Iberpower. Looks like we may see some peeking and poking from Steel, who is going to go through those double doors, but there is someone going to come out on short, and that is going to be Daps. Swag will go back towards the A site, and we have a general rotation towards A from the CTs here. Only AZK remaining on B slope for the time being, and again, Steel with that aggressive position on long, so Juvenile's going to have to watch out there at top mid.
So they're making their way in slowly now, and the flash is a limited grenade coming in from Iberpower. The shots will befall the players of Denial, but they are able to sustain them. They're making their way through only with the loss of Daps. AZK going to come in from the back, but there's not much for him to really accomplish here. He's got the 5-7, might just make the kill. Fugly's really low, but that smoke is going to block him off, and they know where he is there, and he actually does, what the hell, he found a headshot there somehow. I didn't even see how that connected, but he does pick up a kill. But Iberpower next buy
indeed. Let's see if they get the AWP out. Of course they will. Skadoodle going to be rocking the show. Let's see where he takes this. Looks like he's going to go towards long, whereas Shazam is going to be looking for those frags in mid. Hasn't hit anyone on this occasion. Two people have passed. Again, we've got the three-man push on long, which we've seen quite commonly from all teams here on Dust2 across Europe and America.
And I'm behind with a two-man setup. It's going to be Shazam to take the frag onto Skadoodle. Steel might want to feel responsible to go for a refrag here. He does go for it, and it's just going to make the situation worse, unfortunately. Bit of a gamble, but something he felt he had to do. Daze does manage to take down Juvenile. He wanted to push through, assuming that after two players had died, that that would be an open avenue of attack, but that's not the case, and we have a 3-versus-4 situation. Denial once again in an advantage, and cannot be overstated the importance of this match for both teams. Cannot be overstated. Dazed AZK swag. They need to bring the game back into hand. Iber Parrot is starting to get a bit ugly for them.
Yeah, how do they go for this retake? Dazed is going to flash himself through on long, but Nafly is going to be waiting for AZK, and he takes him out. Shazam takes out Dazed as well. It's only swag remaining. He's going to have to go for the save here. Just hanging out by the mid doors. Got a bit of cover, element of surprise, but Fugly knows his angles and shoots him in the head. So it is going to be a 6-1. This is a huge lead here for Denial, so far. And it is going to be a force buy here from iBuy Power.
So to see if they're able to scrap together something here. I mean, do they play aggressive on, let's say, upper dark or to do lower dark take or something? Or how do they approach this? Lower dark kind of shut down by the AWPer down middle, and AZK actually getting legged as well. And so they have to find something here. They're going for the short... the two-man short play. This is the variation now. And Steel might feel like dropping down to CT spawn to provide better mid coverage. But they are going for a bit of a gamble towards middle and B at the moment, as Denial are actually readying up for a play towards B at the moment. They could still switch it up. This could still divert their attention towards short and challenge Steel. And if they make a frag there, they can push the rush. And have to see what they decide to go for. Moving slowly up middle. So it does look like they want that replay. Good opener onto AZK. Daps with the frag. Dazed now turning his attention. Going to get taken down by Shazam. The AWP is looking really good right now. Swag coming in now. Shazam getting dropped. Daps as well. It's a 3-on-3 now. And there's two players in the bomb site for Denial to hold on to this. And Swag has got to try to delay this plant. Delay this plant as Juvenile does go for the rotation. And now Swag has bought enough time for his teammates to come in, but he's going to get taken down. And problems, big problems for IBY Paris. A 2-on-2 off the plant. That bomb is ticking away, ticking away. Denial in good off the plant positions. Fugly, the spray line, not going to find anything at all. And Steel going to take the frag onto Naf. And Fugly going to go down quickly afterwards. And IBY Power are actually going to be able to get the defuse and a round on the board.
Skadoodle does pick up an AWP as well, which is going to be all important for their economy. Denial with lots of money in the bank here. We've got Nafly with 16,000. Many of his teammates around the kind of 7,000 to 10,000 as well. So they're not going to be in trouble for the time being. But the rebuy of that AWP is going to take a chunk out of their money. But they are four rounds up at the moment. They've got six of eight so far as we go to round nine here. So we'll see who can come out on top. We do have the CT economy also looking pretty bad at the moment despite that win. A little bit of money in the bank, but not rich by any means.
And they're going to go for the upper dark aggression. Love it. Love it. Throwing it in. It is risky, but they do have the man on short days as well to go for the spot. Skadoodle going to make the frag with the AWP, and now they're going to go and rotate after showing their hand. IBY Power so far looking good. Steel going to be challenged again. Nice shots by Steel. There it is. There is the spray down, and Steel gets himself the quad kill. Lovely hold onto the short angle, and that's going to feel so good for IBY Power.
They pick up the second AWP, sacrificing the AK that put in all that work on shorts in that last round. So they are going to go to AWP now, and we'll see if they can make it work on this occasion. They've got Skadoodle heading towards long as normal, and AZK is going to go towards mid.
So Denial with a bit more of a passive start to this round, which is certainly a smart decision, and IBY Power going with a more default setup. They don't have anyone in the B site, which is a little bit unusual to say the least, and they have three players almost towards middle, and the man who's actually kind of charge with B is AZK, scope through, and Steel trying to push through long. So lots of stuff going on for Iber Power right now. Denial playing it passively, that could be exactly what they need to do to actually catch Iber Power out here. But so far, no overcommitment, and Denial maybe looking to make a move here.
The AWP going first through the double doors doesn't work out as Swagger's ready for the challenge and takes the Shazam's head off. And we're going to have the bomb going through B tunnel at the moment. AZK's going to get shot, expose himself through the window. Nobody on the site here for IBI Power. They're going to have to go for a retake as T's are making it onto the site. Apple goes down to Daze. Then Daps gets the trade kill. We're going to have 3-on-3 here. Still going to surprise the guy on long. We're going to have a fight for the site now.
That bomb going to get planted by Daps. Oh, that HE going to take him out before it goes down. And Fugly could have been doable with that bomb planted, but there's just no way to plant the bomb now. There's just no way. There's two CTs outside the doors looking very menacing, and Fugly's going to have to try and win a one-on-one, and he's going to go through window. There's the spray, and it's going to be Swag with the frag as we see a 4-6 scoreline. IBI Power stepping it up, getting that economy rolling, and things looking really nice for them now.
Do wonder if we're going to see the eco here. Indeed, we are. Got it all by together in the next round. So P250 is coming out, the two flashbangs. No smokes on the T side. So we'll see if they're going to... I think they're going to go for the long push. And this time we're not going to have three people from IBI Power. That nade does come in and sends Juvenile down to 56 HP, which is going to slow down the T push a little bit. But here come the flashes. So Steel's ready for them. It's going to counter flash as well and peek at the same time.
Good work here so far from Steel. He's been a mighty... mighty defender for Iber Power, but he's not going to endure long enough there. Does take down two players though, and Skadoodle on the angle with the AWP. So patient, so patient. They're trying to bait him out with the shot. Gonna get themselves out there. I think that's a bit of a... Did he leg one and then
he killed one through the other one. Yeah. Yeah,
that's nuts. Don't often see that. And Iber Power looked to be holding on pretty well so far. Daze got them boxed in now. They can't escape through Longhouse. So there's nowhere else to run, nowhere else to hide, and Skadoodle going to find himself the remaining kills with the AWP. And 5-6 now the score, as we are looking at a really nice swing of momentum from IBI Power. It certainly looked bad, but things are looking better now, and Shazam picks up the AWP. Oh, he's got the nice timing with the spawn as well. Let's see if he gets something with this. And Shazam is making his way through there. He's going to be the first man out through the smoke. They get smoked off, rather, so going to back away.
Got, again, the aggressive push on long from Steel, which is going to allow his teammates to rotate pretty quickly. You're going to have to double stack in long in mid as well for the short area. So, Iber Power, sort of early information. Again, that is a great push for them. We'll pay off with an early frag.
Really, really nice pick, and perhaps even the bomb spotted. Either way, Iber Power now settling back to more default positions after taking a man advantage. Daps has also had a bit of his life taken away
again
by Iber Power.
Steel is in a position where he will see the shadow of the T's coming through the door. Same way he plays T when he plays more passive, around the corner by the wall. So just playing the shadows to his advantage there, and again that will give his team lots of information.
Iber Power in a significant control of the round now. They have, I mean, having Steel in that position so far pushed, if they are to hit a play up A, then the rotation from Steel can be in before they even know what's hit them. The pop flash, they want to try to make something happen here. A nice smoke down onto that CT spawn area. And it's a nice play. This is all they could really have gone for, but they're not going to get the execution in. Iber Power looking a lot better now all of a sudden.
6-6. There are three rounds remaining. We do have another buy for Denial, but no AWP on this occasion, as the money isn't there for it. They do need to win this round, otherwise they are going to be poor. You can see the CT economy starting to build now, so we may not see another eco from the CT side in this first half. They're going to go and do the lower B push, so maybe they've been watching a bit of LDLC. Is it going to go their way, though? Netfly does get the kill that he probably shouldn't have, as Daze was there in time and did get his gunfire off significantly prior. But anyway, it is going to be a frag for Denial, and it's going to be four people for IBI Power. No one on the B bomb site right now, but I think they have the info, potentially.
And they're going to get the push down short with AZK. Very key, very, very key position. to hold on to at the moment, and it's only him who can actually do that. And Swag on the lonesome in the B site. Looks like they want to go out of middle here, or at least harass that area and try to fake it out a little bit. But so far we can see, as we are having all the information, that this is certainly the stronger play. Just got to take down Swag. How hard can it be? How hard can it be? And Daps is going to take him down with ease. And a denial now. The occupation of that B bomb site. That bomb will go down. And with two orbs in hand and an AK on steel, it's very unlikely that either power want to commit to a full-fledged retake.
Yeah, it will be hard and very expensive if they do this. They do have the money, however, to buy if they lose this round and probably the round after as well. So it could be worth doing. But do they know? Denial don't have an AWP. If they lose this, then they may put the death gun into Shazam's hands.
Oh, Fugly with the team kill onto Naf, and the kills are coming in, raining in. Skadoodle could make it happen, but it's going to be Fugly who takes the round at the end. That last man standing picks up the AWP. Expensive, very expensive, as you said. Luckily, though, for Arbor Power, they do have a lot of bank. I mean, they lost, what, like 30k at the end there for that retake. But again, lots of bank to take to the last couple rounds. So we'll have to see now if Denial are able to have a successful round here to really go in strong.
That round, the end of that round was pretty damn scary. I thought that was not going to happen for Arbor Power, and all of a sudden there's one Denial player left.
Upper Dark Push coming in here from Arbor Power. It worked once. Why wouldn't it work again? There is Fugly for the spot. He's actually going to keep his life and back away. So that's some critical information that he's gathered. And they haven't lost anything. So it was the gamble coming in from Arbor Power. Nothing happened. And the information that they got at this point is kind of meaningless because it's very early on and Denial can switch up whatever they want to at this point in time.
Indeed. So slow peaks at the moment, but we do have Shazam creeping up the A bomb site, which is going to be a lot of huge information for his team. If the rest of his team can get up there undetected, then this is going to be massive. But we have a return to the A bomb site now, but he misses the shot on Steel. Steel does take him out, and that's going to be enormous for Arbor Power as the rest of the teammates from Denial do start to reach the site. Even now with the Galil, they're going to stay behind the box for the moment and just reload his gun. The Daps could plant for short, but they're going to push and go for some frag first.
Steel going to get the frag onto Juvenile and Daps, and things not looking so good. Return from Fugly, but Naf will go down. Fugly all of a sudden without any friends in the world left alive, and we have a 7-7 scoreline with the pause coming in from Steel. And hopefully this is everything, you know, this fair play here, and there's nothing negative, you know, going on.
That's we saw that situation yesterday on Dust2 as well, where the bomb carrier took the bomb beyond the short plant situation and lost it, and the bomb fell out onto the slope. So that kind of made it a lot harder. But I mean, it is a marginal decision because because they went for the additional gun power to retain the site there. So you don't want to have one person on a gun versus multiple people. So they went to try and get the frags there and take full control of the A-bomb sites. For Denial, last round, and no money for those chaps. So we'll see how what happens there. But Nitro going to be in long. Take Ooh. Over steel positions.
Look at this. Daze going in really hard and heavy down in the lower site, in the lower dark there. Skadoodle does synchronize up with that short push with the AWP. They get a bunch of kills in there. And that was nice. That was really nice. I like it.
Two left for Denial. Things not looking great in this last round. They have one lower tunnels, and the bomb carrier is going to be on short. Only needs to connect with one face to open up this bomb site for the team. See if he can do it. So Doodle is not going to allow that to happen. And Fugly does have an M4. Position currently unknown. Versus 4.
I'm sure that Skadoodle is more than ready, though. Just resting on the angle. Finger on the trigger. And there it is! Those reactions, very nice there by Skadoodle. And we get the 8-7 half here in favor of Arbor Power as they move to the T side, the favorable side of Dust 2. And certainly going to be interesting to see how things go on the pistol. Anything that you're expecting, James?
Pistols.
pistols.
That's very insightful. That's very insightful. Thank you. I'm glad that I asked you now.
You are most welcome. I don't think we're going to see SMGs or rifles. Although we could see SMGs, but we're probably not going to see SMGs.
Well, if they run out of getting kills, and then
if they quickly get a kill, double doors, go back Mac 10. But I think they're all going to spend some money here, so that's not going to happen.
Never seen that happen in the pro match.
No. Because they've all got to buy stuff. Got shopping to do. See, Daps shot to 76 HP through double doors. And denial team swarming towards the B bomb site at the beginning of the round. Gonna possibly rotate back through towards A now.
I like this. You know, it's harder to actually... It's easier to retake A than it is B. So it's smart that they had a much more biased or heavy focus towards B at the start. Now they're kind of adjusting their setup. But the delay from Iber Power, actually, they can still go for this B play. And there is Juvenile on the double doors. He will be able to spot them moving in. But the crossfire could come in as well from Shazam. So Iber Power certainly playing with fire right now if they're going to go for this B split. In comes the smoke grenade. Shazam with the first kill. Might just be able to pick himself up something else. Will escape there behind the smoke. And wow, Juvenile's head gets popped clean off there as we do have Iber Power making the execution into the B bomb site. Good stuff there from Nitro to take down Fugly. And that's going to be a site well and truly open. A bomb well and truly down as Skadoodle picks himself up. One more kill. And two players left, Naf and Daps. And they are going to need to perform very well from this position.
Very strong position in tunnel, so good for denial that they're going towards doors. So otherwise, they would have been in a lot of trouble here. And Iber Power not going to show just yet. But there's a lot of bodies to put into body bags here for denial. That flight is on the site, but does get popped, and Daps is just going to get out of there, not give them the extra money for the kill, save his armor and his defuse kit as well.
So the first half, we actually saw the second round go the way of the team, or the T side, which was Denial. Back then they picked up, what was it, like a scout and just some pistols, and they actually managed to win that round and swing things back around. So we'll have to see if Iber Power are able to actually deter any kind of a play like this and keep their momentum going. And a bit of a scout duel in the middle, it seems. A regular setup from Denali. They do abandon long for favor of a play towards short, which is actually smart because it gives them a fast response towards B. And alright, Daps in the spot. Some players might see a reaction coming out from Denial on short to actually try to slowly suffocate them here. Nice jump shot there from Shazam. They've got to be careful they don't get picked away too much there. Skadoodle with a return. Might just use that grenade to finish him off there. I think he tossed that in. Don't think he actually picked up a kill though. It's going to be... Oh, nice shot there from Skadoodle again. Does actually finish him off. Finally, Nap goes down. One down for either side. Juvenile does creep in, very sneaky, does pick up a kill from Nitro, the very weak Nitro. It's a slugfest right now, it's 2 versus 3. Absolute chaos, and Swaggin have picked himself up an AK. Denial can't find themselves any weapons though. And Iron Power just have to communicate. Skadoodle and Swagger, they got to communicate, put together a play with what they know, and try to secure this round. And Shazam, he's ready for this, look at this. It's like a bunny, up and down, just hopping around. Here they come. Nice shot there from Shazam. Gets the tag on the second player. Swag could just find himself at the mercy of Shazam. Pulling out the 5-7, and that's going to be at the head found by Shazam. What a round.
Denial are serious about these anti-ecos here. Winning both of them after losing both pistols. That is going to hurt Iber Power's economy indeed. They are going to be in a weird situation where some of them, such as Daze, 1500, Swag, 4700. Going to pull out the Deagle is Swag. Shazam almost getting an early kill there as none of these guys have any armor, so that would have been a one-shot kill.
So perhaps in the previous round, you're not quick enough call with how to deal with the anti-eco. You definitely don't want to run into the scout, if possible. And a bit too much dilly-dally maybe, either way. Iber Power still around ahead, just outgunned in this round. Going to go for the quick play onto the A bomb site. Bugly, going to drop a couple players pretty quick there. And their approach is slowed down, it's halted. Shazam going to get out of there, gets quite low. And I don't see the bomb going down here. It's going to be pretty, pretty hard to say the least. There's no smokes to work with, no flashes. And there are actually a few players getting quite low, and Ugly is still on the site. Now Juven are going to come in from another angle, and it's going to be easy, easy stuff for iBuyPower.
Juvenile's been stuck on Car that entire round. He got shot twice by Swag of the Deagle and had 14 HP and had no choice but to just stand on Car for the rest of the round. Managed to escape with his life as well, which is going to be hugely important for the CT economy here. We're going to have Shazam continuing with the scout in this next round as we have the Force Fire coming out from iBuyPower. So we're going to have AWP versus Scout, which might be a surprise for Shazam at some point in this round, but for now, it is going to be secrets.
So a relatively standard setup coming in from iBuyPower so far to start off the round. Gonna see, Steel. He's actually on the Xbox here, and this is not smoked off. Doesn't need to be, but they do want to try to hide their intentions if they can. Still, actually, gonna try to see if he can sneak and see if there's anybody close by outside those double doors. There's no one, and now they have Skadoodle, who is up on short with the AWP, so they pretty much have all the positions they need. They can go for either play, A split or B split. It's all about how they have perceived the setup of Denial and what they think, like which play they think is stronger based on what they've seen. And they are going to go for a bit of a push here on long, interestingly, leaving two players quite far away from the short push. In comes Nitro, does go down. Trade gonna try to come in, but it's not gonna happen just yet. Juvenile does get out of there. He gets flashed out. Good team play coming in from Denial. And in comes the push on short, not so synchronized. And nice shot there from Juvenile, just finishing off Swag as well. Generally good play from Denial here.
I'm still putting in work with that scout. Skizoodle on 13 HP on long here. There are gonna be two quick frags on the A bomb site though. Days trying to stay alive here. We have got two CTs coming through on short though. And that to get the frag. He does indeed. Still gets the trade frag. It's going to be 2v2 here. Skizoodle 13 HP, but he still has that AWP. He's got it down on long as well. Still going to try and hold a site solo.
And Steel just has to delay here. Just has to allow Skizoodle to reposition with that AWP. And they come into the orb of Skizoodle. And Naf does finally take down Steel. But Skizoodle in position, ready and waiting, pulls the trigger. And Naf will fall to the ground. And we have ourselves 10-9 on the score. So both teams still vying for economic control, as we can see. And no one with any cash at all.
Yeah, it's going to be a stretch for iBuyPower, but they managed to get the buyout. And Daps is going to get tagged through the doors and be down on 36 HP early in this round. He's going to be on the B-bomb site for the foreseeable future. We have Nitro just hanging out in the long area. And Shazam looking up mid with AWP. Skizoodle does seem to be in suicide with the bomb, but timing won't allow them to meet just yet.
Nice little flash there into mid to provide some extra threat level. And it's a lot about, you know, providing threat. The B-split would be really effective here against the two players who are sat on long from Denial. And the theory there being that their rotation is so long from long that that it's much harder to get the retake going if iBuyPower get the site relatively quickly. But and also it means the less of a presence usually on middle. And that's what we're seeing. We're only seeing one angle. And there's no two-man setup or anything. So Denial, if they are up against the B-split here, things are going to get really nasty. And it does look like that's exactly the play that's going to come out now for iBuyPower. Moving out, there's the smoke on CT spawn. Steel going to get himself in the duel against Naf. Naf not finding the quick kill. Going to pull out the grenade. Gets taken down in the meantime. And now Daps coming in with the spray. Does take down one. But that's all he's going to get. And that's the bomb now to be planted for iBuyPower. A very clean retake. And look how far away the rest of Denial are at the moment. Skadoodle could put in so much work, but it's going to be Fugly who catches him in the back. And in he goes now through the double doors. Denial can definitely do this. 3-on-3. Making their way in slowly now.
Yeah, Nitro's not going to be able to help his team because he's a while away. Fangos get the first frag and Daze follows up with the second one. Shazam gets one frag, but Swag will finish off the job. We have a short pause coming in here, but let's look at the CT money. Mainly on around 2,000, so I think we're going to be looking at 12.9 in favor of iBuyPower here.
Depends if someone buys a scout. Because they can all afford scouts.
We could have five scouts. Or we could have no scouts.
We've seen some madness. There was, what, like six scouts in one round?
Before? Six scouts in one round.
Was it six scouts?
No, five.
Was it five?
Four on one team and then one on the other team.
Oh, my God. Yeah, four on one team. That's nuts.
It was glorious.
It is quite
Every
cool.
time I say glorious now, I think of Glorins as well.
Oh, Glorins, yeah.
Yeah, all the time. Even when I'm not casting Counter-Strike, I just think glorious, Glorins, glorious, Glorins.
Hmm. Well.
But the question is Glorins glorious?
I don't know, James. I can't answer that.
We'll have to ask him. Or maybe he can tweet us and tell us if Glorins is glorious or if he isn't.
Oh, yeah. I'll
leave it over to you guys.
Right, are they going to actually stack towards along with the pistols here? I don't know. Nitro playing it defensively, so it's unlikely to see anything nuts coming in from Denial early on. Nice little Molotov there from Steel. Spot the first players, and very much in the interest of Denial to isolate one player, and they might just be able to do so. There is, of course, Nitro still outside the longhouse, but they are all congregating. It's a bit of a convivial congregation over at long. I'm going to see Daps actually making his way around. Oh, nice frag there onto the swag. That's a free weapon. Or is it? Daze coming in from short. Does deny that pickup. Very nice stuff. And they're going to go for the hunt on Nitro. He's pretty isolated. So if they do take him down, this is a free weapon. And there it is. Shazam going to be able to pick up that weapon. But there will be no DPs, obviously. So they can't win this round. I mean, although that said, Fugly does pick up a kill on to Steel. So picking up an AK. That's a really nice result there from Denial.
Indeed,
that's maybe the best they could have hoped for. Three kills and two AKs picked up and surviving with them.
Yeah, that's going to definitely help their economy. There's probably not going to be an AWP this round for the CT team. Let's see what that goes with the M4 indeed. So it's just going to be an important round, and still we have not that much economy on iBuyPower's side. So almost every match we've seen this week across the North America and Europe has just been back and forth trades and low economy, which is meant for great matches.
It really does make for the best matches, and already seeing another very passive start. And this was the setup that Denial found themselves getting kind of exploited. There is kind of an adaptation of sorts now that instead of having three on A, one of the players is towards B. So this does actually make it so that the B split is not nearly as effective. It's still going to be effective, but the A play is certainly favorable now with the correct smokes. So again, IBuyPower, they just have to figure out this. And I don't know if Denial have really given them an opportunity to find out the information. So they're going to have to just make a play and hope that it's going to be good right now. They do have to bomb towards the upper dark. So this is a... They could just be putting a lot of threat towards A, cause a rotation, snap a play into middle, catch the guy mid-rotation, and then take the 5-on-2 on the site. And it's like that's exactly what's happening. That they've actually forced them back down into middle. And this could be going very, very well now for IBuyPower, catching Denial out, but they are going to hold the ground. They're going to hold very well. A lot of frags coming into play. Four players taken down, and that's going to be the round blown up for IBuyPower. It was a really nice idea from IBuyPower, but Denial had the execution. They really did.
Swag's going to run for his life with only 14 seconds left. I'm going to try and save that AK. And that is a position where he is pretty much hidden from the world. I'm not sure if his head might be slightly exposed.
I always think about Iron Maiden in those situations. Yeah. Run to the hills. You ever listen to Iron Maiden?
No.
Come on! Come on!
Come on! So Swag saves his AK, a grenade, and full armor. Denial still two rounds behind. Shazam going to pick up that AWP. Let's see now if Denial can bring this back again. This is for LAN. This match is for LAN. Nitro having to play for IBuyPower due to AZK having a PC implosion. So we've got this interesting four-man stack here.
Shazam actually looking towards Low Dog. Might just find the frag. That's the bomb. Now, with that information, Denial can do a lot. And there's a nice forward smoke. And things could get tricky here. They have to recover this bomb. And it's just going to get the pickup there. Denial actually not moving too much, and the push in short is going to happen very shortly. And
the smoke is for CT spawn area, so that will stop the players on B from being able to see. And that Shazam with a sneaky position there, going to see the legs coming in. And Knight is going to get a frag on Fugly and then Shazam. Juvenile getting one back in the name of Skadoodle, but it is a 3-on-3 now, still with only a P250 at the moment, and he is the last man standing, but the bomb has gone down.
Yeah, really nice frags coming in from Juvenile down at pit, really helping this retake come into play. Still going to go down, but it was a really nice round there from Iber Power. You know, their money was terrible. They were just going for some damage. Got some frags, got the bomb down, and they're going to be more than happy. They're going to be well chuffed with that. Chuff means really happy. If you know, for the American dudes.
For the American dudes.
For the American dudes and dudettes.
So, Iber Power. Only one in the lead now. This could go down to the wire. Shazam has named his AWP since we last saw him. But Skadoo was going to get the frag.
Ouch, that was painful. And Fugly's going to come in now. They kind of need to do something, need a reaction, and it's going to be a nice stop on the short play. It was just Steel, the rest of the players towards long, and we can see that it's been more or less abandoned by Denial. So this is actually turning out to be quite interesting. I mean, they haven't seen the bomb just yet.
So you can see Iber Power have left Nitro in the pit, and the rest of the proper teammates of Iber Power will make alternative decisions and plays here. Bomb has been left top mid, and they're going to leave Skadoodle top mid as well. You can see the nades coming in from short, the aggressive positioning. His teammates
sick shot there. B. Through the double doors into the dome. And that's pretty damn nice. Catching Denial on the aggression. That's really smart to wait. Swag going to just lop off the head of Fugly. And, I mean, what can Denial do now? They got played for the fools. Denial just waiting out time in the round. Denial, they couldn't hold their composure. They wanted to find out what was going on. And they walked into the angles, man. The angles. Iber Power had the angles. All the angles.
All the angles, indeed. And they are still going to be able to pull out a buy here and potentially get an AWP. And that's going to be really important. You do see the AWP come out for Shazam. They need to buy here. Iber Power 3 rounds away from victory here. And Denial playing the catch-up now. 2 rounds to the bad. And Iber Power are going to have a little bit of money to buy if this round doesn't go their way. So Denial are going to have to put in the work here and win this round with as many people as possible alive.
Iber Power certainly looking quite strong. If they're able to take this round, things could start getting easier and easier. Could be on the descent, picking up momentum all along the way. Steel, though, might be able to find a pick here. It's going to be down to Denial to try to do a nice setup to force really good grenades and really good team play setups to find angles from Iber Power instead of giving them the open jewels that they want, that they're looking for, that they've been successful at dealing with so far. Iber Power now making their way up towards short. We'll have to see if Seal can make the pick actually towards the A site. Shazam's on point there so far. And there go the flashes. And they don't have to, they just need to try to find a pick. But that's actually going to cause Juvenile to pop out to find some info. And in the meanwhile, Fugly picks up a kill onto Steel. Things are going rapidly downhill for Iber Power in this round. Denial coming in with some great plays. Shazam gets a nice defense with a couple kills. And Juvenile going to wrap around short and find himself the last one. So very nice defense.
That is a clean victory for Team Denial, and that's exactly what they needed here. And again, this is just getting closer and closer, guys. It's 13-12, Iber Power with a one-round advantage here, and they are going to force it, it seems. 3 AKs, 2 pistols. Again, this is for LAN. This is for Milan. That wasn't deliberate.
LAN in Milan. All right. Here we go, that's going to get challenged there. Does drop Steel. And they take over long as well. So, Iber Power, in actually, despite having, you know, being outgunned, it's kind of nice. They didn't leave anybody in pit, but that's fine. But look at the positions that Denial have taken up now on the A site because of taking long like that. And they know that the threat for long is, or for A, is really very real at this point in time. So either power can either play into it, or they can try to play around with it, or try to force a rotation. But there's not a lot of time left on the map, so maybe the simple plays are going to be the better ones. Just rely on that individual skill. And Swag is going to have to perform here. He's going to have to come out with a quick kill. Skadoodle, very much the same, but he's got two players on his angle. It's going to be very tough. Going to just step straight out there. Does take a frag. Shazam going to drop some players. Nitro goes down. Swag goes down. And it's going to be the round for DNL. They tie things up 13-13, and they could very well take the lead now as Iowa Power starts to struggle. Can you see a reality in which Iowa Power don't top two this FACEIT League and get themselves to Milan?
Yep.
You what, mate?
You what? So this is going to be... I'm excited. Just put it that way.
Are you
I'm
excited?
Pretty excited as to what could happen.
James is excited.
In these, these last rounds. James is excited indeed. Might have to pull the pin on the grenade, I'm so excited. So again, we have this stack, this eco stack on top mid that we see from iBuy Power. And they are going to push through to A, but the smoke is there, and that's going to stop them in their tracks. Oh, this nade could be very, very meaty indeed. Oh, the Proschito. Skidoodle down to 40 HP.
So you're trying to say ham in Italian?
Yep.
That's not how you do it.
How do I say it? How do I say it?
Actually, that's a really good point. I did know that.
Oh,
wait.
Wow.
What the hell?
That failed delivery.
Anyway, we'll have to come back to that. Either way, we're seeing Iowa Power pulling back a little bit at the moment. And DNL, look how safe they're playing on the positions. They are super safe. They've got three guys on B. They're really afraid of a push onto the B bomb site. And, oh, that was meaty indeed. That's going to hurt.
Shwito.
And... Oh my goodness. Alright, in they come. Nitro. Quick snap there on the neck of Juvenile with the P250 up on the bomb site. Shazam gonna fall as well. iBuy Power might just be able to take this site. They're gonna get the bomb down actually, in fact. So good stuff for them, and they all picked up onto Nitro. Steel has the AK. This is still alive for iBuy Power at the moment, and Steel's got a nice angle and crossover in case they try to push up CT spawn. He does go for the peak, he gets taken out, and they all fall like dominoes. Dave's going to come in from the back with a P250, but there's just no way. Does get taken out. I honestly can't remember how you say it, which is really weird, because I used that word a lot when I was living in Italy, because it's quite important. It's ham, for anyone who's...
Can I have some ham, mate? Some jambon.
Yeah it's ham.
So we have a here coming out from DNL. They are one round ahead. They are two rounds from victory. So I'm told Fugly is restarting his router. Ping going up to 261. Gotta turn off those BRZ downloads, bro.
The thing is that this was a really nice round for Iowa Power. If we consider how things are looking, they did a lot of damage. All right, the damage economically doesn't mean anything, but that's cool anyway. I mean, it feels good. So it's like the quality is amazing, and it's just super good. It's just super good. But not time for talk of food. Now time for talk of death
now.
And destruction. iBuy Power up against the wall at the moment.
Ah, we've got Skidoodle naked. He couldn't afford the armor. I was thinking Daze could have possibly got the AWP and the Kevlar, but it's not to be for Skidoodle, so he's going to be AWP and AWP open. They're going to leave him mid on his own for the time being to try and find a frag. Oh, that's going to be an opening there for DNL, but Shazam will get revenge, so it won't be long down just yet, but the push seems to be coming in towards short at the moment.
Yeah, they're going to have to make the move now, DNL. They need to really peek with Fugly to see what's going on in middle, and just to confirm whether or not they need to start rotating towards that A bomb site. Of course, then Iowa Power are just waiting a little bit, getting those grenades lined up. They're going to know now. Shazam has to come out huge to save this round for DNL. Does pick up the first kill onto Skadoodle, and there's three players left now for Iowa Power, and they are slowing down the pace. They're not all committing in together. We do have Steel up close and personal with Shazam. Shazam going to miss the shot, won't get the chance to shoot another one. Steel opening up the bomb site there for his team, swapping out for the Dragon Lore AWP, and this is going to look very interesting now. We have a 3-on-3. This round is incredibly important for Iowa Power. It could very well mean the difference between LAN or not for them, as we do see Swag, you know, rocking the angle on the A-long area to stop the flanks coming in. Fugly moving in from CT spawn. Naf from short. And DNL, the retake is in full effect. Steel there with a good angle. Does take the first kill. Fugly goes down. And Daps does take down Daze on the site. Steel returns though, headshot onto Naf on the site. Daps needs to find something. The bomb is way too far ticked at this point. It's going to be the round for iBuyPower, who will tie up the game 14-14. And I do believe we have enough money, more than enough, for Denial to rebuy.
Absolutely, they're going to still be in this match. And this is going to be a crucial round. iBuyPower will be able to buy if they lose this round, but Denial are going to be in a sticky situation. They have gone all in pretty much here. Shazam again with the AWP, so let's see what they can get going. Still looking to get a frag in mid, but no one's going to be there. We've got three people on long at the moment, two of them rotating back to the A site here for Denial, and the remaining two on the B bomb site. So we've got the T's going through to lower tunnel.
Another change of the setup. They've been actually mixing it up a lot now.
The CTs?
Yeah. Yeah, they had a 3 towards B last round, and for the last few rounds, and just 2 on A, often pushing long, or on long, and now they've actually got the more standard setup.
This round has turned into a clutch match now at 14-14, and whoever loses this match is going to be hurting.
And Shazam's in a really key position here. Can he make the frag? Oh, he does shoot in time, but the angle's slightly off, and up goes the flash. That will slow them down, but he doesn't get the kill. That's going to be some free position gained by iBuyPower, and they can still make the call either way, B or A. So Denial holding steady, got to maintain that equanimity and make sure that they don't make anything any calls through the nerves. Oh my goodness,
that's a huge frag for them. She's actually doing so well.
Skadul going to take down Daps. Two frags already found. Fugly with a good return. And the bomb yet to really be committed. And look at the push here from Juvenile, perhaps, on Longhouse. I think he heard some stepping. He's going to fall back now. And Fugly is holding down the B bomb site. This is going to be all about sick individual plays. Once again, nice by Fugly. In comes, oh, Juvenile. It does get taken out there very easily. And Fugly's going to run. Oh! What? Seriously? I totally didn't see that. The tie ran out. How did that happen? How did they let that happen? That was their round.
God, holy potatoes. Did that just actually happen? We need to watch that back. That's insane. That was insane. I was so focused on the kills and holding the sights and so on. And everyone forgot the clock, apart from Denial, it seems. And that is a stonker. They are on match point. Suddenly they can buy that bonus money. This is serious.
This is very serious. And we have a three-man setup outside of the longhouse. It hasn't been challenged that much in recent times. And we're going to see Daze actually the first man. Well, he's kind of flush with the doors there. So they are going to move towards this A split. It feels like iBuyPower just want to get the A split in. The 2-3 A split. It's going to be simple plays. It's going to be about those shots. In comes Skadoodle. Going to make the shots there onto Juvenile. They just get in with almost no losses. Daze is a bit weak, but Shazam can put the stop on here. Does take the first player down, but there's nothing else he can do. The trade comes in, and Denial in a lot of trouble right now. They are a man behind, 3-4, and the retake is shuffling in, but they've got to synchronize up. Fugly's going to stay alive, and Steel just spamming that P250 through the smoke idly. Going to pick himself up to kill Nitro as well. Daps coming in, and it's going to be overtime. Overtime.
It is MR5 overtime on FACEIT. This. Oh my god. iBuyPower are going to be. Their hearts must have been beating there when they realized that they didn't.
Hope they were beating James.
Yeah, I mean, that was crazy.
That was mental. That was absolutely nuts. And now we're going to go into a situation where everything's reset. Everything is reset. And It's what is it? MR5, 16K. This is going to be interesting. I mean, what do these teams do when you get to the overtime territory? It's all about James getting that scalpel. It's all about it's all about that understanding of how the teams have been playing their setups going into that you know, all those 30 rounds that were just played, and just do you change it? Do you just keep going with what was working? I mean, what do you do? I mean, I'm not sure if either team is really going to want to change up that much. We already saw Denial with a lot of nice variations to their CT play. I was really enjoying how they were mixing things up. And it felt like they, they're giving themselves a lot of chances because it didn't seem like Upper Power figured out a lot of their setups.
Indeed, but as we've seen previously in these situations, the teams will be adjusting to behaviors they've seen earlier on in the match, and those behaviors or the adjustments may decide the fate for these two teams here. So we're going to have Ima Power continuing on the terrorist side on this first half of overtime. Once again, positioning changing here all the time for Denial. You can see they've got Crossfire set up in mid at the moment, where previously they had nobody in mid in the early rounds here.
Yeah, it's just very sensitive, and Denial are really nice so far at making the passive CT plays, where they don't give away easy picks. And it's not even about giving that away, but we're going to see Shazam on the angle, and he's going to defeat Skadoodle and drop down. Beautiful stuff. The flash comes in. There's the next player. Too quick, too fast for Shazam. Steel gets the kill. And Iowa Power make their way onto the bomb site slowly. Bomb is actually down in middles. This is actually kind of a weird situation because Steel's all the way on the A site now.
Uh-oh. That's the face.
Face demon. And, flash coming in. Steel trying to make the kill. This is awkward. And there goes Nitro. Going to get the bomb. And the second frag on Daps. This is madness right now. Dazed. Doing the 180 there, does take the kill onto Juvenile. We've got Bugly trying to survive, but that was madness. It was really weird, it was a crazy round.
The bomb changed the entire dynamic and kind of ended up working in Iber Power's favor, mainly thanks to Steel managing to survive while his teammate came for the flank from the T-spawn, T-long area. So that's going to be the first round to Iber Power. In this first overtime, this will be the first team to 21 rounds that will take the match. Steel down to 22 HP, double AWP setup coming out for the T side here, using the most of that money.
Wow, three orbs is just...
Oh, triple orb!
Yeah, three orbs on T side is nuts. That's like absolutely bananas.
Wow.
Bananas and nuts.
Sounds Steel, like though. A pancake.
Oh, not quite. There's going to be Daze who gets taken down as well. That's pretty heavy losses. And the problem is not necessarily that they lost two players, but that the two of the three remaining have AWPs. Not the most dynamic weapons ever.
It is doable, though, especially with a minute remaining here. But the frags just keep going in Denial's way. They haven't lost a single player in this round yet. The worst damage they have is that from 73 HP. So looking good to take this round quite cleanly. And Iber Power may have to opt for a save here, because it's not cheap to buy three AWPs in one round.
Alright, so Swag and Nitro left.
The bomb has been disregarded, and that's going to be Nitro down, and Swag will be the only one to remain. Can he save his AWP, or is he just going to try and get some damage in? No damage to be done there, and that's going to be a clean sheet. Some sweet revenge there in round two for Denial. 16-16.
Yeah, that didn't go so well. That did not go so well. We'll have to see if they're able to establish something here. That was a big investment as well. I mean, they do have a lot of money. They do have to all just have the 16k, but still, got to be careful. Don't want to run out too soon. You see the movement coming in towards that B tunnels. Skadoodle with a nice little pick there onto Shazam.
And as we did see Skadoodle in suicide early on in this match, and again, you could see Shazam aiming for suicide. They're expecting to see Skadoodle, but unfortunately, Skadoodle was still upstairs, and the crosshair in the wrong place. This gave him the edge Skadoodle needed to get that frag.
There's a nader up onto Short as the push does commence. Nitro on long, got a jewel coming up, and he's going to lose it against Fugly. Very well held there by Fugly on long, but the bomb is going to go down. And Steel there making his way down the crossover.
Importantly, because Denial still have control of long, that means Iber Power can't plant the bomb for long, which means if Denial can retake here, then Iber Power can't abuse that long distance with the AWP, but they can abuse the short distance, and Skadoodle gets the first frag, Neflag gets the second one. He's the last man standing for Denial here, however, and the time is running out. He's going to be stopped by that monitor for a while. Faces two at the same time, and Dazed will get the frag. 17-16, Iber Power.
Something that I thought was pretty cool is that we didn't actually see a lot of challenges up middle with the orbs in the first 30 rounds. We didn't really see that very much at all. Neither team really going for those jewels. especially coming in from DNL. They played it very passively, but now they're actually bringing the double AWP to play. Typically, we saw, you know, Shazam just settling on long or settling on the short angles, but now they're being much more active. And okay, where are we seeing? We've got Shazam,
long,
who's going to be on long, and Naf, who is going to be on B. So defensive setup, but man, it packs a punch with those double AWPs.
They've left the mid alone again, so they've gone back to their regular CT setup that we saw on the second half of this match. And we have a four-man stack going towards short. The bomb just staying around mid for now. Got to make sure he doesn't go fall down, but he will be okay for the time being. He's going to be behind his teammates, going to try and deny vision of the bomb for as long as possible. That smoke is going to go down. He once again into the CT spawn area. Nitro rips Shazam's head off. Juvenile gets a trade frag, and again, that will be important with regards to the plant from IBP power if Juvenile can stay alive here.
Steel has been on point, and he is delivering once again. Nice entry there against Juvenile, going to secure the bomb plant. And DNL now looking at a pretty hard retake. They've got four players left alive for IBP power as they are smoked off. And these grenades are really buying a lot of time here for IBP power. The bomb is already getting quite far ticked. And we can see that they might even start being a bit reluctant to go for this. Fugly does get taken out, but two quick frags found on long. They're going to sprint off the back of those. In they come. Daps with another great one. Finds the head of Skadoodle. Naf going to come in with the AWP. Maybe go for the cover shot. He gets the cover shot. Is there enough time? Is there enough time? Oh! Oh, he gets the defuse. I don't believe that. And a denial somehow pull out a miraculous round.
These guys are playing out of their skin. This is absolutely insane. 17-17, there is nothing between these teams, quite literally. Two AWPs coming out again for DNL. And just the one on Nitro this time for the T side. He's going to go for the spawn. One HP! Oh!
That hurts, man. That hurts. How did he live?
Steel gets revenge for that damage. Just rips Shazam's head off. And Shazam's been so important here for DNL, but he is down early on in this round.
Yeah, Shazam's not happy with that. And you can see them swapping up the guns, which is really smart. You're going to put the AWP on the player that's really weak. You can play from the back with that long-range weapon. And AKs on the players with more health. And we can see Steel going to try to make those entry frags again. He's been really, really, really good on those. But it does get taken down. But Skadoodle does make the refrag. Got the 3-on-3 situation with the bomb being ferried up now onto the A site. And it seems as if IBP Power found more success with the A bomb site in the last 10 rounds or so. And oh! The jump shot! Fugly getting cute there. And that's going to make a really big change to the dynamic here. We've got Nitro left on 1 HP in pit.
Nitro could die to a flashbang here, as we saw AZ yesterday.
But is it planted safe for pit? I don't think it is. No, it's not. It's not planted safe for Nitro, but he might just be able to make the frags. It does take down Naf, coming in from crossover, keeping Swag safe from that angle, which is really important. But the jump shot coming into play once again. Nitro's got to try to get the shots, and does get taken down. Would have been very exposed to go for the angle to cover the bomb, and we get another round for DNL. I cannot believe that they're making these rounds happen. I honestly can't believe it.
Yeah, that's crazy. So that plant, Nitro had to be on the platform to get the frags when the bomb's planted in that position, but he couldn't make it up there. With only one HP, any bullet would have killed him, and any bullet did. 18-17 here to DNL. And again, this is just so close between these two teams. They both want this pretty bad. We've got Steel on the 30 bomb and Skadoodle not far behind him. Daps and Fugly pretty close as well.
All right, so this is just, I don't even know what to say with this. It's really funny because I feel like IBP Power made the nice adjustments. I think that A was generally weaker than the B and mid defenses from DNL. And they started to hit the players. We saw them getting on the site, like with the plants, loads of times. Loads of times it was working out for them. But, you know, enough of that. We're going to see IBP Power now on the CT side as we commence the second half. DNL with the one round advantage. And we do see two AWPs, Skadoodle and Swag, playing with the AWPs. And at a very default setup from IBP Power, although nobody in the B site itself.
DNL need three of these five rounds in order to make it to Milan. And Swag gets one of the five kills needed to bring it back to 18-18 here. Bomb is in the B tunnel, and we do have two AWPs. on the iBuy Power team, just the one on Shazam. For A, we're going to have Daze go for the peek, and Fugly's going to say no, no information for you. Daze isn't going to see the bomb there, so that's no more information for the CT side. Trade's coming in mid, and the bomb is going to head probably towards B now.
Swag is ready in the site, got two places to look in. Oh, nice shot there by Swag. Oh, no scope coming in as well. Oh, the triple. Swag is on fire, and that's going to be the round there for iBuy Power. 18 to 18. We're all tied up once again, and that was nuts.
How many AWPers do they have on the iBuy Power
team? I don't know, man.
Primary AWPer Skadoodle, secondary AWPer Steel, and Swag as well. I wonder if they've got five AWPers on their team. You never know. But anyway. It is 18-18 here. And are we going to go to overtime too? Are we going to be here until the sun comes up?
That's the question. I'm pretty sure. Here we go, though. They are pushing through middle and trying to get themselves into that B play. And it's not finding much traction just yet. They haven't got the bomb planted. In comes iBuy Power. They can still yet delay this bomb going down. Already, it's going to be Skadoodle coming into play. Does get taken out by Shazam. Important frag. And Denial and iBuy Power at each other's necks, 3-on-3. That bomb ticking away. And just setting up for these smokes and the flashes for this retake. They're all on the door and window angle. Nafto, really nice position, going to take down too easily. And Nitro will get a revenge frag, but he will get taken down in Denial. Going to win the rounds. 19-18.
Denial two rounds away now. iBuy Power with still lots of money in the bank. Going to be able to get that AWP or more should they desire it. Looks like they could. Are they going to go for the double again? So Spag's going to continue with the AWP, and why not after that great work in the two rounds ago. So again, Denial, two rounds away from victory here. First to 21 will win in this first overtime. Otherwise, we're going to look at 20-20 here for one of these teams.
And they're going for the quick long play, but there's three players there for iBuy Power. This should be really easy to deal with, but it's going to be Juvenile opening things up with some good spray behind from behind that smoke. Nitro coming in, and it's just madness right now. Madness all over long. Both teams clashing. Denial stuck in the mud. The bomb is down. And iBuy Power looking fantastic at the moment. They're a man up as well. They got the rotation coming in. And Steel does take down Daps as well. So now they're two men up. This is certainly not the right play for Denial in this round, that long play, now that they have, well, now that they're going to know that, but
that all-important bomb changed around very quickly there. It was exposed around the smoke as well, wasn't even in the smoke, so Denial in trouble here. This is looking like 19-19, but with 33 seconds left, it's they could still get considerable damage in here. So let's have a look at where these guys are going. Swag does take down Shazam. Fugly will be the last man standing for Team Denial. Just going to go and try and get some damage in here. But with two rounds left, I don't know how much that's going to matter.
Okay, so 19-19. Two more rounds left to play. Who is going to give first? Gonna see the double AWP remaining for Skadoodle and Swag, and Shazam the lone AWPer for Denial, and they're gonna send a few players towards upper dark, just keep this position under control. So Fugly's been doing well actually on this, and they're gonna go for the push here. In goes Steel there for the frag. Okay, there it is. It does come onto Daps and forcing Fugly back. He's quite low as well. Naf gonna come in, does make the refrag onto Skadoodle. That's really good work from Denial. Oh my goodness, Naf makes the next frag as well. iBuy Power were looking really good there. Naf came out of nowhere with a quick double, and now the round has been flipped on its head. Swag does take down Shazam though. We're back to a 3-on-3, and neither team can seem to find or hold on to an advantage for all too long.
Daze has no... he had no primary weapon for some reason, but he's got another AWP. But it's going to be Nitro on the site. He could do with a knock right now. Does get the first frag, though. That's going to be important because Fugly's only got 15 HP. Could go down to the flames right now, but the smoke's going to extinguish it. The bomb is down in the B site, and it is going to be a 2-on-1. Daze could definitely still do this. But the trade frag comes in from Juvenile. Match point denial here. This is it could be Ibai Power's last chance saloon.
Denial. One round away. One round away from winning this match in overtime against Ibai Power. And this is nuts. This is crazy. I can't believe what I'm seeing. We're going to have... it looks to be just a basic setup here from Ibai Power. They are switching things up a little bit. They don't have quite the long focus as they've had previously. And we're going to see, actually, Denial trying to bust out onto Long. Nitro actually going to get the stop there onto Juvenile. And so they've lost one man already. They found out something. They found out that there's a guy playing Long. Can they infer what's happening in the setup? We're seeing that, or are they just going to decide to just hit a play onto middle here? It's so many options still remain for them, despite being a player down. As long as the team play is working out well for them. And it says Shazam on the angle towards short, looking into A. He's quite pushed here. Skadoodle is very ready for this, though. We've seen he's been very consistent with this. There's the first kill onto Daps. They are now 3-5. Naf has to silence the AWPer. He will. Naf gets the kill on Skadoodle, and the rotation is going to start coming in very quickly from Ibai Power. They don't have the best position. The smoke's everywhere. Denial can still do this. Shazam does go down. It's a 4-on-2. Naf and Fugly still able to win this for Denial. In comes Ibai Power once again. Dazed with a nice frag there onto Fugly. Naf has to clutch. He has to clutch for Denial. Two quick frags there for Naf. It's not going to be enough. It's just too much work. It was too big of a job. And it's going to be Ibai Power bringing us to overtime number 2. Bomb has been defused. 2 is Due in Italian.
Good to know.
Yep.
So we are at overtime number 2 here. Again, nothing separating these teams. Steele's enjoying himself, although I'm sure this is a bit gut-wrenching for both of these guys. Well, for all 10 of these guys, in fact, because
this is one of the coolest matches we've had, I think, just generally speaking, just from the stakes, the teams, just everything. It's just so awesome. This is great to see. And already Swagger's going to get tagged at the start of the round. That's not nice, is it?
Swag down to 20 HP on the B-bomb site here. And this is a bit of setup. We've got double AWP again for the CTs, and of course, just Shazam rolling with the Dragon Lord for the Ts. We've got 3 Ts top mid, 2 poking around in B-tunnels as well. We've got Swag behind the box. He's going to be in control of B-tunnels for a while yet, and we'll have to see where the Denial players choose to assault. Ooh,
great battle.
Is so sharp today.
Yeah, that was really nice. That was really, really nice. And I'm probably going to settle to the 2-2 approach on either side, and rotation should come in, but it's going to be down to the players on B to hold this. Denial with some sick stuff, though, man. They've been hitting some amazing shots. They get themselves in the site, and the bomb's going to go down. There's just no way that Ibai Power surely can do this, but they are going to... They might as well try. They got so much money at this point in time. They might as well go for it. And they're going to see that that's going to be the case. Still, they're going to try to see over the smoke. But it's very hard to retake B without anyone from Dark to distract. These angles are really easy for the terrorists. As that bomb is surely to explode soon. And they can, the best they can do is try to keep the players within the bomb radius, but it looks like a Nitro's going to go down at the end, and the Denar going to take the first round there.
So, this Ibai Power needs to get some rounds on the board here, because funding these AWPs is going to be difficult going forward. So still going to pick up the M4 there. And oh my days, Swag with 8 HP. 20 wasn't enough. It's going to be sent down to 8. And Skadoodle's going to drop fast as well, which is really bad here for Denial. Still going to get a trade kill on Daps and pick up the AWP. So ooh, Nitro down to 7 HP as well. I mean, this is not going well. And Steel's putting in work here. Another one. He's giving them a one-man advantage. But the bomb is going to go towards the B bomb site, and we're going to have Swag looking at the sneaky position here. Going to have to change up his normal angles because of this HP deficit.
It's going to be interesting to see if he can actually pull something off from this position wouldn't expect it. And there it is, the standard check. And it's going to be Nitro and Steel now. And Steel just seeing someone run past in the distance, not going to connect the shot. It's not easy. It's not easy. And Steel is... I mean, what do you do right now? He's going to switch out for the rifle. It's just such an hopeless situation. You've got an AWP in your hands. It's like, well, I guess I could pick up a rifle and try to go for it. There's still lots of cash. But they have to worry about the money now. That, you know, DNL have been kind of powering through. And the money, look at that, look at this. The money's almost gone.
Indeed. If they lose this, then they may lose.
They actually have to eco if they lose this. That is really, really bad. And we're going to see a quick play into B. Straight away in. It's going to test the defense here. In comes the first shot from Swag. Takes down Daps. Refrag coming in, though. And Daze in the back. Going to take himself a couple frags by car. Oh, and sick stop there. Great work with the USP at the end. And we do have Shazam coming in from middle. Putting one into the body of Nitro. As Ibo Power look pretty steady now. And it almost feels as if that B push was the best thing that could have happened for Ibo Power. I mean, for DNL to decide, you know, let's rush B, guys.
Shazam has the... He could still do this, but I think...
Oh! Are you serious? That's nuts. Again, just crazy stuff from these guys. Shazam.
That's gonna hurt. God. If that frag is the beginning of losing this round for Ibo Power, I mean, how much does that hurt? I was going to say, see, look, this is Italy, man. these guys want to win, but this smoke is burning their time down here for DNL. But you know, even if he doesn't win the round, the economical damage here, which is being caused, is colossal, and it's going to be hard for Ibo Power even to continue in future rounds. Shazam almost got vision. He could still do this if he finds the first break.
And with the first shot, in comes the second player, Daze from the angle. And as you said, we have to check the money. They're going to pick up both the orbs. And
That's crucial.
Maybe it's just the power of the Dragon Lore.
Maybe it is. Oh, boy.
First Rodar.
Okay, I have a power one round behind. They pulled that one out of the bag and did really well. Going to have a double peek here. Shazam just going for a timing pick and probably a whisker away. Somebody got a haircut there.
Oh dear, Daze did get tagged there. He did get tagged. 36 health for him. Already softening up the players of Ibo Power. DNL have been looking so awesome tonight. So awesome. Juvenile might just find himself in a 1-on-1. It's going to be Steel. Pops out the doors. Does take the kill. And Daps does see the weapon get tossed over by Steel as he picks up the AK. So, an early round advantage here for Ibo Power. They do have two players who are quite low, though. I'm trying to set up for another play. Making them up middle now, and it's hard to make a call. It's hard to be the guy who's going to make the mid-round call. There's the pop flash into middle. They're going to go for the split onto B, it seems. Naf actually makes the entry onto Steel, and there's the smoke down. This is very possible at the moment now for DNL to make their way into that bomb site. There's a nice pick from Shazam. Oh, Naf comes in with a sick shot onto Swag as well. It looks too easy. And Skadoodle and Nitro going to have to do some mad maneuvers to actually bring this one back.
Naf has been popping heads. He's got so many headshots this game, it's ridiculous. We've got both players for Ibo Power in CT spawn. Looks like they are going to go for the save here. Again, their money is not doing fantastic, to say the least. So they're going to have to conserve their cash if their team are to get a buy here. Possibly looking for that second AWP or just a safe haven. But they are being hunted.
Yeah, it's very interesting now. And you know what? It'd be so cool to see either of these teams in Milan. Like, it's just so awesome for either result. You can make, like, so many... Like, for example, for DNL, it would just be amazing to see another American team at an international LAN.
Yeah.
Like, that's so cool.
They have such sick aimers in America. Like, we're just seeing some excellent aim duels here. I mean, the headshots coming out from both of these teams is insane. We've got Steel top fragging at the moment with 38 kills across both teams, and Nafly not far behind with 36. So, just fantastic play. This is a really, really good game to watch.
Yeah, it's looking really good. They do have the three-man setup, Ibo Power on long at the moment. And Also, you know, quick to note, I mean, it'd be amazing just to see our power make it as well, just because it's always super fun. Just watching them at LAN is just really fun. Anyway, and we're going to see DNL with their passive opener. And actually, Iowa Power may just be playing into this. They're getting aggressive in the longhouse. It's not the most favorable situations trying to do this spam battle against these AKs. And DNL might be gifted some easy kills in the opening, but Iowa Power are calming down a little bit. We're seeing them back away. And oh,
wow.
Actually just pulls out the scope there and moves away just as Steel peaks.
DNL are running out of time though. Maybe they're expecting an eco here or something like that, but 40 seconds left and they are nowhere near taking a site. There's only one person on a B-bomb site here. If they move fast, maybe they can do this. It's going to be Swag. He has no AWP this time. 35 seconds remaining now, and still Swag's on his own on the B-bomb site. Does get a timing nade in, which will do great damage. Daps on 27 HP, but they have to push fast.
Yeah, Swag is certainly in a really important position now for Iowa Power. Does take the first kill. Gonna get spotted now at the back of the site. Goes down though, just for one kill. But his teammates, they're all on top of this now. They're gonna get in. The smoke is gonna kill some time, but the bomb is only just going down. Great Swag there onto Nitro. It's gonna get 3-on-3, and that is some sick grenade work. And Juvenile follows it up with the AWP as well. Steel. He's going to have to come out with something here. It's got to be big. It's going to be Juvenile taking another kill. And there is Daps at the end. That was a beautiful three kill there from Juvenile.
So we're going to be looking at 26 rounds here for DNL to take this match. This is a war of attrition. This is carnage. This is madness. Bomb will explode.
Is this real life?
Is this real life? Says DDK. 38 to 36, top fraggers for each team. Iowa Power probably just having a discussion of what they're going, how they're going to approach this next half. Again, every round is going to be crucial for them. They are three rounds behind. DNL with the lead once again. They've been in the lead in these crucial times quite a lot most of the time, and this is the biggest lead they've had. And this is their biggest opportunity to win here. So Iowa Power are going to have to come out with something huge to get back into this match.
All right, so Dave's calling the ready there, and they're going to go into the match. As James said, it's only two rounds, and then I'll win this. And Iowa Power now find themselves on the T side. Two ops coming in for DNL. And nothing found by schedule across the doors. The smoke doing its job. Very calm start at the moment. Very basic setup from DNL as well. And on their CT sides, they've shown us a great proclivity towards passive play.
We've got Nathfly with the AWP this time. He's been such a huge fragger with the AK for his team, but he's going to pick up the AWP on the first round of this overtime 2 second half. And we have a push potentially through mid, just teasing, faking.
They're dropping the bomb in the middle there. And now that I think about it, it reminds me a little bit of NIP, some of the DNL CT play we've seen. And they are very strong at the passive holds. And we're going to see slowly as they edge their way up here. Just both teams waiting to see who's going to give. Because I'm actually wrapping off some shots here, down towards the smoke, down at middle. But it's going to be actually the assault up onto the site he's going to have to worry about. And initially, he does with the first shot. And it looks like they are going to carry the bomb up there. And it's one player dropped down really fast. It's Steel, as usual, does get taken out. Good work there by Shazam. And he's going to have to do more here. He's got to get more. Shazam gets number two. Number three coming in as well. The quad kill coming in from Shazam. And Nitro is left over at the longhouse. And he actually doesn't even need to do anything more. Shazam has already done enough. And is he going to get himself the ace? Not quite. But no. He's already... Damn it, James! You know how much I've been resisting that all night. I've been like...
I had to do it.
There's so many times where I'm like, oh, you know, they've got the DNL on the site, but no, I can't. You can't say that.
This is match point. One of many here for DNL. Iowa Power have no more margin for error. They have to win every single round to bring it to overtime three here. They are without choice.
That was some Cali-type AWPing we saw there from Shazam. Reminded me of the Stockholm play from Cali, but... we're going to have to see now if Iowa Power can bounce their way back into the match. So far, DNL have just been, you know, sitting and waiting. for DNL to come to them. Sorry, for IOPAR to come to them, and they've been getting the frags. It's more or less as simple as that.
So the bomb is waiting. Around the B bomb site at the moment, we have support in the name of Swag for the bomb. We've got two plays on shorts for IOPAR, which will be Steel and Skadoodle. So they're looking for openings here. We have the passive play here from Nitro. Just going to keep an eye on long, make sure nobody pushes, no flanks come in. So I think Skadoodle's going to be the one that they're going to need to open up this round for them. And his second half, Shazam, is going to be in various positions on the A slope. We've seen his little sneaky peek through the boxes in the gap to see the players coming in. But at the moment, he's going to hold the angle on the middle of the site. And it looks like we may have a three-man push here on long. Juvenile is in pit and will be waiting for them.
If they have the nades to shut down Shazam, A is really nice right now, but Shazam has been a beast. And here they come onto long. It's going to be Juvenile with the quick peek there. Does manage to make himself one frag before going down, but it's DNL losing player after player after player, and IBP looking fantastic. Steel once again with the drop down and wrapping his way up crossover onto slope for the frag onto the site. And Steel has been playing really well for IBP tonight. He's been doing a really remarkable job. In comes Daps though, and Steel does deal with him. Naf gets the return. It's a 2-on-1 actually, so it's pretty doable for Naf. Just has to get a first quick kill. Swap out
oh, he's got
the AK.
This is bad fry by Power. We've seen what he's been doing with this so far. If he aims in the right place, he could.
There's a snap. Flick. Not yet from the flag. There's Swag, though. Pulls out the pistol, and it's going to be the round fry by Power. They keep their life alive. Keep themselves alive in this match.
Well, they do keep their lifeline alive, I suppose. But again, it's just going to be match point all the way here for DNL. All they have to win is one of these remaining rounds. That's how close they are to Milan, to Prosciutto, and all that jazz, to Prosciutto, Prosecco, other things starting with P.
And again, we're seeing a similar setup from DNL. And they have actually been showing a lot of different like variations from where the players are standing. This is actually looking the same as the last round, but have been seeing a lot of minor variations, which is really nice. Always keeping IBP guessing. And
Peroni, that's a P.
It is. Good Italian beer. And we're going to have to see now if Steel's going to be able to keep keep the entries coming. But it's actually the AWPer that does the peak. Skadoodle is going to make the frag there. And see what else he can get. See if the reaction comes in. Maybe the Molotov to stop them though. Incendiary. And so they do make their way into the A site slowly, but they don't have to go really, really hard with this. He can take it slow. He's coming out of the smoke there from CT spawn. Does pick up a kill and steal. Now he's just going to wait for his teammates. That is so smart. And it's a 4-on-4. The bomb does go down.
They have managed to plant it for long.
Oh, Nitro's position is so sick right now. Oh, he's going to go down, though. He could have potentially taken out two of the guys coming in from the rotation. Now it's going to be on Skadoodle.
Oh, Skadoodle's in the flames and he's flashbanged.
Oh, he gets the shot anyway, but he does burn to death. And now it's a 2-on-2. Swagging with a sick shot there onto Juvenile. And Naf once again coming in. Might just be able to save the round. It's going to be quick. Going to be fast. And it's not going to happen. It is a Swag to make the kill. And IBP do a good job to keep themselves alive.
Two more match points here for Team DNL.
Oh, the money though, DNL. They lose this. Then they have to eco. They lose this round, they have to eco.
They have to force. It's going to be the last round.
Yeah, basically they're money screwed after they lose this one.
The aggressive play here on short from Shazam, and he has no one to. Oh, they've gone for the double stack actually, so they've got the angles covered. Steel's going to be in for a surprise.
Great play there. Then I'll take down Steel, and that's a really big loss. Steel's been providing a lot of great entries.
He's made the 40 bomb as well.
Yeah, he's made the 40
bomb. Shazam's looking for a 40 bomb with an AWP. How crazy is that?
I have to see now what IBP decide to call, because they've lost the man. They've gained no information really from that, except that there were two players on short at that time. But that doesn't really help them now. And we got DNL with a nice little crossfire going in to any B split play up middle, and you know they should be able to deal with that quite well, but it's still IBP just sitting around. Looks like they're setting up for the A split at the moment.
IBP running out of time. running out of choices here. If this A push doesn't work for them...
Oh, Shazam does go down though. They get two really fast entry frags on long. This is looking really good now for iBuy Power. And Daps, Naf, and Fugly can still save this for them though. And prevent that money screwed situation on the following round if iBuy Power are to win this. Bomb does go down. In comes Daps though. This is so hard. Does get taken down immediately by Skadeedle. And yeah, this is impossible. They've got four players left. They don't know where most of them are. This is so difficult, and they are going to go for the save, which is smart. But Diver Bow might make this three overtimes. We could basically have 60 rounds here. Oh, Naf gets taken down. That's actually huge. They really needed to save those weapons.
Oh, the money. I just forgot.
Yeah, basically, they are really money screwed. So this should be the next overtime coming in now from iBuy Power. If they're able to... They should be able to win this. I mean, the money is not super good for Denial. They're not going to be able to buy a lot of grenades. So they do have an AWP in play, a couple of M4s, but...
Oh, the 257 bad as well.
Yeah, this is going to be really interesting now. Do they go aggressive or do they just stay passive? There's lots of choices to be made. A lot of pressure on Shazam to really make a good dent into the team of iBuy Power now.
Okay, he's got no armor either. And I think we're going to be looking at 25-25 here, guys. There's nobody on the B bomb site now. And the rotation's coming in from iBuy Power. Two people still on A for Team Denial. They don't want to get caught on the rotate, so they're kind of committing to the site. But the frags are just not coming in for them. It's going to be Shazam versus the world soon if Fugly doesn't get some frags here. And Sam's got no armor either. No armor, no kit.
Yeah, this is looking really nice for iBuy Power. Some great picks. And Fugly might get caught in the back. And I mean, we saw that the upper dark play came in from Denial. They needed to do something. And that was the something. But they didn't execute well enough. And so that's to the credit of iBuy Power. And that's going to get them the third overtime. So we're going to be looking at... I mean, we've played 50 rounds, so...
More! We need more rounds!
More rounds!
More rounds, more AWPs, everything.
More everything. We've had some crazy crazy overtimes.
This is insane.
In the Europe, with the European League, we've had some... I think the most we had was 60 rounds, I think.
Yeah. Hellraisers love a good overtime, but I mean, this is on a completely different level. There is so much at stake here.
Yeah.
There's a long-ass trip to Europe at stake here.
Yep. And I mean, it would be such a game changer for Denial to get to that land.
Fettuccine, linguine, bikini. That's what's on the line right now.
I think we need some linguine and bikinis. All right. I'm a pound with the standard setup on the round. They got the presence on dark and short to give them all those options that they need. And. Denial, you know, we're just, once again, they're sticking to these passive plays. They hold the money back again, so they don't feel the need to take any risks. And we only usually see the aggression come from them when they feel they need to take a risk. So, I certainly would be interested to see if iBuy Power go for the A play, because if they do, Denial really set up well to deal with that. I think the B play is going to be stronger here, but iBuy Power can they figure that out? They're going to go in, and this is it. Steel just goes for the drop all the time there, and it's really effective to have a player down there very quick. He does get taken down by Daps. In comes Skadoodle, though, for the return. And Naf is stuck in the site now. He's got to hold on. He's got a delay. Here's Fugly from CT spawn. It's actually kind of a crazy position. He gets straight through the smoke. Almost gets the frag on day. It's not quite, though. And now comes Shazam with the AK. And Naf is still alive in the back of the site. He's managed to survive for this long. And you can see how powerful that is. That means they haven't got the bomb down. There's so much pressure. In comes a frag from Juvenile. The bomb is finally going to go down. Oh, look at that swag. Bunny hopping into Naf's face. Pulling out the AK. Hitting the shot into the face. Shazam putting in work though through the doors. The one-on-one. And Shazam wins the duel for the round. Clutch stuff there from Denial. From Denial's Shazam. And this game is insane. I don't even know what is happening right now.
Denial take the lead again in overtime three. Let's look at the bombs we're seeing here. We got a 40 bomb from Shazam, the 40 bomb from Steel. 40 bomb coming soon for Swag and for Daps and for Nafly. This is insane. This is crazy.
Them 40 bombs.
It's crazy.
It's crazy.
Is that a good Italian accent? Nope.
Sure. Why not? Alright. I can teach you an Italian pickup line in a minute, James. I've heard about your pickup lines.
I don't want to get assaulted by women.
No, it's really pleasant. Anyway. It's charming. So we're going to see a quick pick there onto Nitro from Juvenile. Skadoodle does get a good frag, though, in return. So we're all squared up here, but that's, of course, to the benefit of the T's. In comes Naf, though. Nice little flick there onto Steel. Good adjustment. And we see a small advantage taken by Denial. So, Ibo Power, what do they do? What do they do now?
Bomb is still at top mid for the time being. 50 seconds remain. One man disadvantage now as we have a peek. Oh, and again, the end of the barrel exposed Fugly's position before he could get a peek on the T. So they got that split second heads up, and it was heads off for him. Three versus three now. The remaining T's have to decide where they think the extra man is, and they think it's Shazam. At B, so they're going to go towards A.
Can Shazam do it? He's been so on point. Oh, he gets a tag. How did that not result in the kill?
He hit both of them. He
hit them both? That's nuts. Again, Shazam going to reposition. Nice Molotov, actually. That's really, really nice. That's going to burn Skadoodle down really low. Skadoodle almost getting killed by that. They're both so low. Naf has the AWP, though. The grenade going to take down Skadoodle. Can even switch out for a rifle if he wants to. Dazed and Swag, though. Going to be very tough to deal with.
Doesn't pick up the AK.
Oh my goodness, gets into a shot into the back of Dazed.
There's no time.
Yeah, it's just gonna have to back away now. So, very close rounds. These rounds, everyone's dying.
Swag, one HP.
I like the Iberpower sticker, it's nice.
That sticker's like £14 or something.
Really?
Yeah. I've got one on my AUG.
Dignitas hologram, man. That's also kind of sick.
Yeah, that's top tier. Let's be honest. Those reflective eyes are just crazy. I think Swag's got his covered in Dignitas stickers. Or someone has on one of these teams.
Okay, nice shot there by Steel. Opens up the round. Who is going to break? Who's going to break last time? Last overtime. Denial had a... Well, hold that fort. We're going to get a slow push. In upper dark. It's like Iowa Power ready to deal with this though. First kill then, the second coming in from Swagger Days, so really well played. And that's going to allow them to get into B pretty easily. And not much left for Denial to do now. And.
Snap!
That gut shot there. The hip shot. So it's really interesting because Denial got really far ahead on the first. Oh, sorry, the second overtime, right? I think it was, yeah. So
They were three rounds ahead.
Yeah, that's the biggest lead we've seen, I think. Nitro has the Dingcat stickers.
Okay. Nice frag there. 2v2 now. Trying to keep hold of these guns. Denial. Hyper power. Just frag hunting and getting fragged. Not going to make it in time. Flashbang doesn't come out. And it is going to be... Finally, Iber Power have a round advantage in this overtime. Even in normal time, it was Denial who were leading the charge to 16 for the most part. But to Iber Power, they could take this and run with it.
Just the level of focus from Denial, especially in their position, not being the super experienced team, not being the team that has had their reputation or Iber Power. Can you imagine the intensity? Can you imagine the focus? Can you imagine them ever having played, these stakes in recent times?
It's amazing. I think this match has been going on for 2 hours now.
Yeah.
This is a slobber knocker.
All right, well, I'm probably going to make their way out here. And they do have Fugly there, who is on the angle as well, right behind Swag. So got to be careful to see if they're able to make the kills. Coming into this, they don't have a good setup to deal with it. They got the three-man play on B, and Iber Power are taking their time with this. They don't want to make any missteps. Methodical
They're just play. Waiting for the pick. At some point, the CTs are going to have to try and find out some information.
It is. They're walking the razor's edge, and it's going to be the frag for Steel, but he does get taken down to 2 health. Stray grenade is all that's needed to take him down. Steel going to get taken out by Fugly, but Skadoole with the return. And all the frags for Iber Power, all the kills. And of course, we're going to see Juvenile coming in now on the rotation, but Iber Power looking a bit better, and it would certainly be massively gutting here for Denal after having that 3-round lead in the previous overtime.
Well, look at their money. Daps has got $2,700.
Oh god, that is.
It is the last round, but this is not going to be easy. Shazam getting the AWP. Oh, it does get the armor as well. So Daps going to be picking up a FAMAS that's been thrown over for him.
Scar.
No, UMP. Oh no. Okay. So oh, must have been a misbuy.
He's actually picked up the SIG. The SIG. Alright, so actually dropped the SIG, so just bought it for the hell of it to scope into Thomas' doors. But nice little push there from Juvenile. And they are taking an early advantage. Ooh.
Short lower tunnel push. That's going to force Iber Power's hand as well. They are all over the place at the moment. Swag top mid will find Nathlight, which will give them a bit of breathing space. Planting for short this time. That Shazam is very close, up close and personal with the 5-7.
Oh, 5-7, baby. Only one frag, though. And we're going to see the 1-on-2 coming in to play as Fugly does take down Skadoodle. Still plenty of time if he can just find the kills. Going to quickly approach the bomb site. Nice shots, just finding Steel somehow. Does take him out. Pistol comes out. There goes the defuse. And just 3 times. And there goes the peak. He gets the shot onto the Swag. He has time as well. He's going to get the defuse. What a clutch there. What a clutch from Denal's Fugly. That's the 3 kill and the defuse.
We could make a top 5 highlights from match alone. This is crazy.
This is like the Lord of the Rings trilogy.
Round 56 coming up, people.
This is like the third book now.
They haven't even had a toilet break yet. Now we've got Shazam and Steel equal on frags here. This is something else.
So what do they do going into the next half here now, Denial and Iber Power? How, like, this is the thing, it's Dust 2, it's like one of the most standard maps, and Denial, and every time they've been playing the CT, they've been playing their setups, every time we're seeing the standard rounds coming out from Iber Power. But neither team gives. There is no give in either team. Dap says, I'm so dehydrated. And Steel says, I'm going to Milan.
These AWPers, it's going to come down to these AWPers again. And again, we've got the double AWP on the CT side. So we're going to have Swag in the B-bomb site with the AWP and Skadoodle going towards A. Going to stay around the site for the time being. But had some aggressive peeking there in the tunnels from Denal, but they will back off.
Man, this is so hype right now. Overtime number 3, it's the second half. And
more overtime. All the overtime.
All the overtimes, baby. Denal coming in now to a bit of a convergence towards that middle position. And we're seeing, of course, you know, Nitro is ready with the pop flash. And it's got to time it well. Day's going to get the shot. Then the grenades can come in. There it is. This is the team play. This is the setup. Going to work. And Nitro going to find himself the frag. They've shut down the mid play. And now Juvenile, once again, is left alone. And he's against 4 players. I don't think he's going to find much love here with his AK-47. He does get the first kill, but easily silenced by Steel in the follow-up. And 29-27. Iber Power actually taking a lead. Is this the first time we're really seeing Iber Power actually looking like they're kind of ahead?
Yeah, absolutely. And they've extended their lead now from 1 round to 2. They are 1 round away from tying for another overtime, 2 rounds away from victory here. They're now going to need to take 4 of these remaining rounds if they want to go to Milan. Otherwise, we're looking at overtime for them. So, again, we've got the 2 warps here for Iber Power. We have Shazam, who is going to be on long doors. He may get a pick here, might even get 2 the way this is going. Oh, he rips Skadoodle's head off. That's like a million damage. Steel gets a trade frag, though. Wasn't expecting him to be there. So good support there for the AWP. Nice flash.
It's not over. Steel does go down in the end. But he killed two players in the process. There is... Look, they got the boost. They're still on the boost. This is... They're so strong. Free frag from Daze. That's so smart. And now it's just two players left. Swaggy with the first kill. There is the flick shot from Swag. And Denial all fall down.
Is this the end? That is the question. We still have a buy coming out for Denial here. But they again, now it's their turn to not make any mistakes. Shazam has been getting... He's still getting the frags there. But is being taken out of the game in these current rounds. And they need him to survive and kill yet more people if they are to get back into this match. He's been doing insane work for them. And so has Naflo with the AKs as well. This is probably the stronger side for Denial. Just the fact they've got the AKs there, they can one-pop these heads. Shazam looking for some action in mid. He needs to be careful, though, because there's more than one person there.
And he is going to actually switch up the attention now towards middle as the frags are coming in. You can see that they do have Nitro really close there. Very dangerous angle that Asimov. The Berserker Asimov. I like it. As Skidoo lies in wait there on crossover. So Denial looking to perhaps bring themselves together on a play towards B. They do have the upper dark control still. The man to shut this down is Nitro though. Look at that close position. He's going to catch Shazam in the side of their head. And it's going to be Fugly that gets the trade. But that is a really big dent now into Denial's aggression. They have to try to come together on a play. And Skidoo, oh, he misses the shot. Does get out of there, though.
He hasn't missed that once this entire match.
He has been holding pretty damn strong in these positions. And they come again to go for the challenge. And the drop from Juvenile is going to reward him with a frag, but Skidoo is going to get the bomber down. And there's 15 seconds left in the round. The bomb's down on the site. Nav picks it up. He's got to go for the plant. Skidoo takes the kill. There's no time now, surely. The frag can't quite be found by Juvenile. And Skidoo. Skidoo with the triple, and that's... Is that it?